Right, this unit is an Octave Plateau Kitten. It's Kitten 2. It's in fairly good condition, not used very much. I was bought second-hand way back in the late 80s, probably early 90s. And looking on the back of the unit, you can see the main switch and the mains socket, which is a replacement from the original bound-in mains lead. And then on the right-hand side, you've got pedal inputs, which you can use foot pedals to control various parameters. I've never done that. The glide foot switch is just a closing switch that either enables or disables the glide control from whatever setting you've got. Then underneath, the system expansion. I don't know whether you're going to use the outputs from this, but this is two lots of outputs. I think there's a high note, low note priority thing going on, but I don't understand how that works for output, CV and gate. The critical one is the external CV and gate in. The digital keyboard output's very specific to Octave Plateau and won't be relevant to anything else, I don't think. And finally, on the right-hand side, you've got the audio in and out. Yes, it is in and out because you can bring audio in and send it to the voltage-controlled filter and use it to modulate external audio. Then outputs are simply high-level and low-level, the same thing, but one's about 10 times the voltage of the other. Let's go through the features of this device. So I've got the thing switched on. It's a single oscillator version. The CAT was the dual oscillator. This is a single oscillator version. And I've got the thing set up at the moment with no modulation, the low-pass filter set for no effect, effectively, noise level low. I'm taking a feed out of the low-level audio output just because it's convenient with this recorder, but there's also a high-level audio output. And we've got the thing set at the plain vanilla triangle waveform. And let's see what that sounds like then. Of course, the one thing that is set here is the envelope shaper. I've got a little bit of an envelope on there. So there we are. Now, there's a separate video showing this thing being tuned externally using an external MIDI to CV converter, which is now left home, but the video is still there on this channel. There we are. So this thing's got a number of oscillators, or sub-oscillator. Well, it's a single oscillator, but it's different waveforms available. So if we listen to the pulse waveform, and in fact I've got the pulse width set to about, let's try it at about square wave, and there, yeah, I was altering the pulse width between square wave and fairly fine pulse. No idea what the actual width is at that point. This pot there has got a missing black inlay for some reason. I'm sure somebody could paint that black. Right, so that's got pretty harmonic rich there. There's also a ramp waveform. Sawtooth waveform. So there's also sub-octaves. So if we listen to the triangle wave and then bring in the first sub-octave, so that's an octave below, and that's two octaves below. So you can play games with this and put some of stuff in there. Let's just quickly look at the business of the keyboard. You can switch the keyboard off if you wish, using the keyboard off. Now that's not having any effect. And at that point, it's still triggering it, but we need to tune it then, I guess. So what are we getting? There we are. So we've got to trigger it through the keyboard, but then tune it via that. Now let's put the keyboard back on. And this is kind of before people bothered putting pitch wheels in. There's a very crude pitch bend control, which is, I think, plus or minus an octave. So, not a very useful performance control, but there we are. And you can also immediately switch the pitch of this thing up and down by plus or minus two octaves. There's a glide control, which you might know as portamento. So if we do that, and then familiar with some sounds of the 70s with that sort of effect. Then the next thing you've got is the modulation. So you've got very... Let's back off a moment. Let's just have a look at the filter, the voltage control filter, while we're at it. So if we take a... let's bypass the envelope generator and have that on all the time. Let's put some... let's get some actual harmonics in there. And let's see the effect with the lowest Q resonance. I'm just using the thing as a variable low-pass filter. There we go. Or to almost nothing, obviously, and then all the way up to no effect. But you can then increase the Q, which is that resonance around the cutoff, which makes life more interesting. The static thing. If you play your cards right, you can actually get this thing to self-resonate. There we are. So you can jack the Q up so high that it resonates. Now, the only thing is that I think the Q pot needs sorting out. That slider, and I have found it intermittent from time to time and not been able to get it to resonate. But certainly by design, it's intended to resonate. So let's go back to here again. I'll switch off the bypass. So as far as this amplitude modulation is concerned here, using the transient generator, ADSR envelope generator, that's so the usual. All the sort of standard things you can achieve with that. And you can also force that envelope generator to repeat and just have it being triggered by the low frequency oscillator, which is the next thing we'll look at. Or you can have it gated, so still being triggered by the low frequency oscillator, but only when you have that thing, you have the keys pressed down. Now the next thing then is this low frequency oscillator, which is ticking away there, can be used to put modulation onto the system. So let's speed that up a little, and we take again a plain vanilla thing, and what we'll do is we'll bypass the envelope. There we are. It's a bit of a pain to listen to. Let's just it down a little bit. So now we can adjust the amount to which this low frequency oscillator affects the frequency of the main oscillator here. And here we've got a square wave, so we're actually toggling between two frequencies. Okay, useful for alarm noises or something. Now let's go to a sine wave, that's classic. sine wave oscillation there. There's a sample and hold here, which is sampling and holding either the voltage controlled oscillator or the noise generator. There's a noise generator there if you really want it. Have a white noise generator, pinky whitey noise. And so that sort of samples and holds fairly random stuff. And there we are, that's sampling noise. So we get some nice weebling noises on there. It's nice being analog here because you can just set it to absolutely any level you want. And then you can apply, if you're using the pulse generator there, you can, as we've shown, you can vary that at a static sense there in DC, or again use the LFO with the sine wave there. Kind of more subtle modulation going on there. And finally, we have to go back to, well, no, we don't have to go back to the envelope generator. There you can modulate it by the envelope generator. There we go, very nice. So endless number of ways of modulating this. But here's the next thing, you can modulate the frequency of the low-pass filter, the resonant low-pass filter. So, okay, that doesn't sound very interesting. Let's get some harmonics in there. Now, we can start to modulate that using the sample and hold, say, or just a straightforward sine, or the VCO. Now here's a clever trick. You can actually switch off the VCO audio so that you're simply relying on the filter. And okay, is that interesting? Well, you can hear now that we're going to modulate the filter with the VCO, and that will really have an effect if the thing's resonating. And especially if you turn the frequency of the VCO down. So you can actually play the filter if you wish, using the keyboard control. A lot of options here. And again, add a bit of noise level in there, add a bit of noise in, and get some fantastic sounds there. And obviously, it can be controlled by the envelope generator, or even just simply gated on and off by the keyboard. Gating takes the trigger from the keyboard but doesn't use the transient generator. It just stays open as long as you've got the key down. So going back to where we were originally and turn the audio on. You hear the switch is a little bit rustly, but this is a 30-year-old piece of kit. It's never been tuned or anything internally, so it's exactly as originally set up, but it's in pretty good condition, I think. And then turning all of those things down. Whoops. And just in case anybody thinks there might be an issue with bleed through. really hear anything significant there. A little bit of noise gated through. But you'd probably use a noise gate or something to take any muck out if you needed to. And then again, if we listen to the level of modulation. Let's just bypass. So there we are. That is The Kitten by Octave. We'll be right back.